Alright, so we're reloading some 300 blackout, and I've actually already done 5, 17 grains, and what we're using as projectile is a spear TNT. Hopefully you can focus. I guess not. It's 125 grains or hollow points. They're meant for varmint shooting, because they expand and they explode. Fragment, I should say. And I won't be hunting any varmints, but that's kind of what I want. Now, the powder we're using, very important, is Winchester 296. It's actually made for handgun, like Magnum stuff, 44 mag, 357 mag. It's chemically identical to Hodgdon H110. Excuse me. But I couldn't find any of that, so I just went with the Winchester. And it works really well in blackout. A lot of people use a little gun, but they're not getting good velocity for the lighter supersonic loads, and that's what I'm going to be shooting. And we'll show you some load data here. So, let's see if I can show it. What we're doing is 125 grain right here. It's not a nozzler boat, ballistic tip, but it's close enough. And the starting load is 15.7 grains at almost 2,000 feet per second, 32,000 PSI. The max load is 18.5, and that C right there denotes that it's compressed. That's not really a big issue, but we'll see what happens. And it's topping out at 2,200 feet per second and 52,500 PSI, which is, frankly, that's a lot. But what we're starting at is we're starting at 17, and we're working up in 3/10 increments. So I did some 17s already just to get it going and to dial in my seating depth, which is 2.06 inches. So we're going to go up to 17.3 right now. Then we're going to do 7.6. Oops, I miswrote all those. Then we're going to do 17.9. And then we're going to do 18.2. And then we'll end at 18.5. And then, of course, you got to look for pressure signs along the way. Jacked up brass. Flattened primers. So if you see the primer right here, it's on the sensor. Primer, you want to see nice rounded edges, kind of where it meets the brass. If it starts to flatten out and become almost like it's one unit, one thing, then that's a sign of increased pressure. If the neck starts to split or you start seeing like some case head separation, that's also a very bad sign. So you got to watch your brass too when you're working up loads. So we'll start here. I have a little holder for some 308s that I was doing earlier. So I usually do all my starting rifle stuff by hand, just because I'm not convinced that my case drop is going to meter correctly every time, especially when I'm doing it such, you know, 3/10 of a grain isn't really a small amount. 1/10 of a grain would be, but I like to be precise with these, because then once I find out what works, I can start what they call splitting tenths, and I can find out what works best in my rifle, which, by the way, is a 10.5-inch barrel from Bear Creek Armory with a 1/8 twist. So we're going to go 17.3 here. 12.5, hope you guys can see that. Oh, that is way too much. Okay, so just kind of scoop it out a little bit. We're at 21. See where that puts us. 19, still really high. 18.3, so we're exactly one grain over. Let's see, 17.1. So I like to shake it, settle it, make sure it's accurate. 17.1, we're just going to tap it just a little bit. Sorry, I'm kind of sick, so you're getting here some sniffles. So we were 1/10 of a grain over. 2/10. Oh, wait for it to settle. Hopefully you guys can read that. Yeah, so we're 1/10 over. Now, when you're doing stuff by hand like this, there is no excuse to not be absolutely precise. It really isn't. There we go. 17.3. Let it sit, make sure it's settled. Cool. So we're going to drop it into one of these. Now, just based on the shape of this, my funnel won't fit properly, so I got to take it out by hand. Drop the funnel. Pour it in, and I do all my charges first, and then I seat. You can see here, It's not exactly a compressed load, and I have quite a bit of room still until it reaches the neck right here. So, that's good. Now we're going to load them on my progressive press, but... So it's a relatively small projectile. Alright, flat base, so that right here, it's not bow tail. I mean, the corners aren't diagonally cut. So it doesn't quite have the same ballistic coefficient. It's not quite as good, but it's well suited for this application. And also, if you can tell, it's got a hollow point, which aids in expansion and fragmentation if your velocity is high enough. So, see if I get you close enough. Alright, so we take our brass and powder. Now I've already dialed in this for our proper overall length of the cartridge. I bring it up because my bullet, you know, it's not exactly, the mouth isn't flared enough to hold the bullet. I don't want to mess with the mouthing yet. And then you just press it in. And there she is. Now I am going to double check. I'm just going to use some calipers here. Zero it out. Oh, zero. There we go. About 8,000ths off. Now the dot. Perfect. And I'm super anal, so that's just how I am. It's, even if it's 1,000ths off, I want them to be dialed in. Now, this isn't going to be for precision shooting, but I want to eliminate as many variables as possible to get to make sure that it's really my powder charge. That's the single variable affecting my groups. Now, I don't have a chronograph, so I can't really test velocity. That's another investment I should probably make sometime soon, but I've got a lot of other priorities going on. Want to put money into. Now I can set up to 5 rounds of cartridges in here at a time. It's a little bit easier, it's a little faster, but you really don't want to get complacent because that's how you get double charges, undercharges, and otherwise poor performing ammo. Beautiful, aren't they? Look at that. There you go. So that's me reloading. I started with factory Federal brass, which I got in that other unboxing video. And these are like super fresh. The flash holes look great. The neck is good. They're annealed. There's a little bit of flaring, it looks like. Insides are beautiful. Federal, good quality. They're relatively cheap. I believe they were like, the brasses that are 20 cents a piece. So I don't normally buy, actually that's the first time I've ever bought factory fresh brass, but I didn't want to form my own brass from 223 cases yet, because that involves investment of more capital, and I don't want to really want to do that. So yeah, that's me reloading my 300 blackout.